Welcome. My name is Deko Mohammed. It's another beautiful day that Almighty God has granted us. So today we want to focus on our final class on the books of original entry. There's another question that I want to tackle here. I still remind you, if you are not subscribed, please subscribe, like, and share to this channel for more free videos. Welcome all. So there's a question here of books of original entry. The question is, Kawira started a business on 1st January 2016. The following is a summary of her transaction during the month. So, we have invoice received 2016, 2nd January, Jiran Limited, KSH 80,000. 18th, Shuma Limited, KSH 140,000. 26th, Mwanaisha Traders, KSH 160,000. Invoice issued 2016 January, 5th, Mungi Traders, KSH 50,000. 20th, Motor Traders, KSH 150,000. 25, Yuagari Traders, KSH 70,000. Credit note issued 2016 January, 10th, Mungi Traders, KSH 6,000. Yuagari Traders, KSH 4,000. Lastly, credit note received 2016 January, KSH 30,000. 24th, Chuma Limited, KSH 8,000. 30th, Mwanaisha Traders, KSH 12,000. Required, prepare relevant journals to record the above transactions. So, that's a simple question that I'm testing on books of original entry. The trick here, remember last class we said, when we purchase goods on credit, we prepare purchase journal. When we sold goods on credit, we prepare sales journal. But here we have not used purchase or sales. Now the trick is to identify which one is sales on good on credit, which one is purchase good on credit, which one is sell return, and which one is purchase return. You have to remember that whenever we invoice a receipt, that is purchase on credit. That's a trick here. So I can say when we receive invoice received, this is purchase goods on credit. When we receive an invoice, it means we purchase goods on credit. So Jiran, Juma, and Mwanaisha, all of them, we are going to prepare purchase journal for them. When invoice issued, this implies sales goods on credit. Whenever we issue invoice, it means we sold goods on credit. So Mungi, Moto, and Juakari are going to prepare a sales journal for them. Credit not issued. It means we issue when those people who have sold goods for them on credit, they have returned. So it means this is sale return, which are purchased on credit. Lastly, credit not received. It means purchase return. Those who purchase goods on credit have returned goods, so we give credit not received. Having know that, now we can prepare the journals. You already know that invoice received is purchase goods on credit. Now I can wrap it so that I prepare. So we begin with the first one. May I have the question here, but also I hope you have already got. We have the date. Remember the format.
So this date 2016 January 2nd, we can say 2nd Jiran, yeah, Jiran, detail is Jiran. Invoice number we are not being given, so we can just leave it. Ledger folio, this is purchase ledger. Then the amount for Jiran is 80,000. Next, date 18th, we have Shuma. You know, we are not given the invoice number, so we just leave it a blank. The amount is 140,000. Yeah, 140,000. Next is 26. We have Mwanaisha. We are not given the invoice number, so we just leave it. Purchase ledger. The amount is 160,000. So we are done with the invoice received. So we total that amount. We total it. Yeah, 80. 80 plus 140 plus 160. I'm having 380,000. So the total is 380,000. So you see, total posted on purchase account on the debit side. And we are done with this question. We are done with it on the debit. So that's how you record. The only trick was that whenever we receive invoice, it means we purchase goods on credit, so we prepare purchase journal. The next is sales journal. Still will have date, detail, invoice number, ledger folio, lastly amount. So we come to this invoice issue. 2016 January 5th, we have Mungi tariff. The date is 5th. Mungi traders, we write Mungi. Mungi traders. Invoice number we are not given. Ledger folio is sales ledger. The amount for Mungi traders is 50,000. Next is 20s. We have 20s. We have Moto traders. Moto traders. This is sales ledger. The amount is 150,000. Next is 25th. We have 25th here. We have Juakali traders. Juakali traders. 70,000. This is sales ledger. 70,000. We sum up that 50. We add 150. Add to 70. Coming to 270,000. So you see total posted on sales account. On credit side, 270,000. So we are done with the purchase journal and sales journal. Now we want to go and see the purchase return and the sales return. Since I'm done with this, let me wrap the first part here. Purchase and the sales journals. Here I have the question here. I hope you have copied. Since I wrap it, I hope you have copied. We are remaining with the last two, the sales return and the purchase return. We have the credit note issued. That is sales return journal.
We have the date, detail, the credit note number, ledger folio, amount. So, you see, out of these people that we are selling goods to them, we want to see how many returns. If you are told, on crypto issue, we are told 16 January, Mungi returns 6,000. This Mungi, which is sold goods to him, 50, he returned 6,000. So we have here date. The date is 10th. You think this Mungi? These are not given. The crypto number are not given. Ledger folio still says ledger. Then the amount is 6,000. Next date is 28th. You have Juakari traders. We are told they return 4,000. This sales ledger, we are not given the amount. So we total it 6 plus 4, that comes to 10,000. We say total posted on sale return account on the debit side. Remember, sales was on the credit, so sale return is on the debit, 10,000. Lastly, we're going to do the credit note receipt, which is the purchase return journal. So we have purchase return journal. Purchase return journal. So you have here the date, the detail, credit note number. You have the ledger folio. Then we have amount there. So we are told on 2016 toll of Jirani. So on the toll of, we have Jirani as the detail. He returned how much? 3,000. Next we have 24th, we are told Chuma. Chuma returned how much? 8K. 8,000. Lastly, on that is Manaisha. Manaisha traders return how much? 12K. So total coming to 23,000. Then we say total posted on purchase return on the credit side. Remember, purchase was debit, so this will be credit side. Remember, this is still purchase ledger. We are not given the credit number, so we will not write. So that's the end for the question. The trick here was to know the credit note issued and the invoice issued, the invoice received. Whenever we receive an invoice, it means we purchase goods on credit, so you have to prepare the purchase journal. Whenever we issue invoice, we prepare the sales journals. It means we sell good on credit. So that was the trick of this question. I hope it is clear now. Remember, last time also we did the general journal, which I used to record the sale or the purchase of the fixed assets. We also have the cash receipt and the cash payment. All of these are the books of original entry. Remember, we did sales journal, sale return, purchase journal, purchase return, cash receipt, cash payment, general journal, all of them. I hope it is clear and you will enjoy. It's bye from me. Hopefully you, for those who don't subscribe, kindly subscribe, like and share for more free videos. Thank you and welcome.